are discussing the Cauchy's linear equation. This Cauchy's linear equation is also called as a particular case of the Legendre's linear equation. Why it is called the Legendre's particular case of the Legendre's linear equation? Because we know that the standard form of the Legendre's equation is a naught ax plus b whole square y double dash a1 ax plus b into y dash plus a2y equal to some function of x. Suppose if a equal to 1 and b equal to 0. In this particular case, this Legendre linear equation will be converted to Cauchy's linear equation. If we substituted a equal to 1, b equal to 0, then the Cauchy's equation becomes a naught into x square into y double dash, a1 into x into y dash plus a2y equal to xi of x. Then this equation will become sana Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation. In this particular case, we declare the Legendre's equation as a Cauchy's linear equation. So Cauchy's linear equation is converted to the Legendre's linear equation is converted to the Cauchy's equation under the condition a equals to 1 and b equal to 0. Now we come to the substitution. Substitute t equal to log of a equal to 1, b equal to 0. Put a t equal to log x. Then x equal to e raised to t. And we get an also assume the substitution x into y dash equal to dy. X square into y double dash is equals to d minus 1 into y. After the substitution, equation 1 will reduce to the standard form. Reduce to the standard form, that is differential equation with a constant coefficient a naught d d minus 1 a1 d plus a2 of y equal to xi of e raised to t. That is called the function of t. So it will be the function of d. F of d of y equal to function of the variable t. Now this equation will be the differential equation with the constant coefficients in terms of the variable d. Here also capital D equal to d by dt. In this also we consider x cube y triple dash is equals to d d minus 1 d minus 2. And also x raised to 4, y 4 dash is equals to d, d, d minus 1, d minus 2, d minus 3 of y. We follow the same procedure. That kind of the equations will be called Cauchy's linear equation. So the Legendre's linear equation will be called Cauchy's linear equation under the particular case if a equal to 1, b equal to 0. Then the Legendre's equation becomes a naught x square y double dash plus a1 x y dash plus a2 y equal to xi of x. That equation will be called Cauchy's linear equation. So now the substitution of this Cauchy's equation will be put a t equal to log of x. X equal to e raised to t. And also we take the substitution x into y dash is equals to dy. X square y double dash is equals to d d minus 1 of y, and convert the given Cauchy's equation into a differential equation with the constant coefficients in terms of the variable t, and we follow the remaining procedure as it is of the follows. So that equation is called Cauchy's linear equation. Now we are moving to the procedure to solve these Cauchy's equation. Again the same procedure will be followed. The given equation is directly in the standard form in the some cases. In some cases it is not directly in the standard form of the Cauchy's. So we just have to apply some techniques to convert the standard form. So that the standard form is a naught x square y double dash a1 x y dash plus a to y equal to some function of x. After writing the standard form, we put a substitution t equal to log x and then x equal to e raised to t. And we also assume the substitution x y dash equals to dy. X square y double dash is equals to d d minus 1 of y. Here I am taking only the second order, so these two substitutions will be taken. If it is third order, you also use the other substitutions also. After substituting these values, again the equation is converted into the form of the differential equation with a constant coefficient. After getting the differential equation with the constant coefficients, we find the complete solution, that is y equal to yc plus yp, that we obtain in terms of the variable t. And then at the last end of the procedure, again we resubstitute the value of t. Substitute t again, we get a y in terms of x. So we just have to be resubstitute the value of t, we get the function y, or we get the solution y in terms of the variable x. So proceed, I'm explaining the procedure once again here. The given equation should be directly in the some cases directly it is in the standard form. A naught x square y double dash, a1 x y dash plus a2 y equal to xi of x. If it is third order, then the standard form is a0 x cube y triple dash, a1 x square y double dash, a2 xy, a3 y equal to some function of x. After the standard form, in some cases it is not in the standard form, we have to convert it. After writing the standard form, take the substitution. T equal to log x equal to e raised to t, x y dash equal to dy, x square y dash double dash is equals to d, d minus 1 of y. And after that, we get a differential equation with a constant coefficient. And then we find the solution by finding the complete solution by the complementary function and particular integral. And these again will be in terms of the variable t. Again, resubstituting the value of t, we get the y in terms of the variable x. So that is the procedure of the Cauchy's linear equation. Here I am taking an example based on the problem on the Cauchy's equation. Solve x square d cube y by dx cube plus 3x d square y by dx square plus dy by dx equals to x square log x. Here you can see the equation. It is look like Cauchy's, but not in the standard form, because third differential operator should have an x cube, but it have an x square. So convert it to in the standard form. Again, you can also see the second differential operator should have an coefficient x square, but it has only the x, and also dy by dx should have an x. So it is not directly in the standard form. So to convert it to the stand, to convert it into the standard form, we just have to be multiply the entire equation by x. Multiply the given equation by x. We get x into x square becomes x cube d cube y by dx cube, 3 x square d square y by dx square plus x dy by dx equal to x cube log x. Now it will be the standard form of the Cauchy's equation. Now put a substitution t equal to log x, x equal to e raised to t, and then x into y dash equals to dy, x square y double dash is equals to d minus 1 of y, x cube y triple dash is equals to d minus 1, d minus 2 of y. Then we get, put here x cube d minus 1, d minus 2 plus 3 into x square y double dash is d minus 1 plus x into dy by dx is d of y equal to, so x equal to e raised to t whole raised to 3 log x equal to t. E raised to t whole raised to 3 becomes e raised to 3 into t into t. Now simplify the LHS terms here. After simplifying these terms, we get only the d cube y equal to e raised to 3 t into t. Just open the bracket and try to simplify it. You will get the d cube y, and the RHS will be e raised to 3 t into t. Now write down the auxiliary equation. So the auxiliary equation is m cube equal to 0. Hence, m equal to 0 comma 0 comma 0. Because it is third order m cube, so we'll get a roots 0, 0, 0. Now we have a complementary function. All the three roots are repeated. So c1 plus c2t plus c3t into c3t square into e raised to 0 into t. E raised to 0 is nothing but a 1. So our complementary function is c1 plus c2t plus c3t square. Now we are moving to the particular integral. Function is c raised to 3t into t divided by function of d, that is d cube. So now it is of the form e raised to at into t divided by f of d. That is your type 4, e raised to at into v by f of d. If the function is in the form of e raised to at into v by f of d, shift d to d plus a. Here the coefficient of t is 3. So shift d to d plus 3 first. Then our particular integral is e raised to 3t into t whole divided by d plus 3 whole cube. Open the cube. That is of the form a plus b whole cube. We get a d cube, 9d square, 27d plus 27. Now simplify this v by f of d plus a. Here the v is in terms of the t. If it is t, then it is a function of polynomial. If it is a polynomial function, follow the division procedure. So to follow the division procedure, first write down the increasing powers of the d of f of d, that is 27d, 9d square plus d cube. Follow the division procedure, 27 plus 27d plus 9d square plus d cube, and your function is t. To get the t, by the term 27, we need a t here, and we too have to cancel the 27, we divide it by 27. If you multiply the 27 to here, we get a t. Now 27 into derivative of t by 27 is plus 1. Second derivative of this term is 0. Third derivative of this term is 0. Reverse the signs, minus 1. To get the minus, I am taking the quotient value in terms of minus, minus 1 by 27. 27 into minus 1 by 27 is minus 1. 27 into derivative of the constant is 0. Second derivative is also 0. Third derivative is also 0. Again, the reverse the sign, remainder is 0. So your quotient will be your particular integral, that is t by 27 minus 1 by 27, that is 1 by 27 into t minus 1, that is your particular integral. Now write down the complete solution, y equal to yc plus yp. Your yc is c1 plus c2t plus c3t square plus 1 by 27 into t minus 1. Your t equal to log x. Then the complete solution is c1 plus c2 log x plus c3 log x whole square plus 1 by 27 into log x minus 1. That is your complete solution of the given Cauchy's equation. That is the procedure to simplify. Here we just missed one term, that is e raised to 3t. So I am just writing it e raised to 3t by 27 into t minus 1. So e raised to 3t. E raised to 3t is nothing but a x cube. So that is your complete solution of the given Cauchy's linear equation.